Wow. Okay. And Deborah Garland. I look around this room. Now all these sitting here, students, parents, family members here to support and celebrate. And I feel this incredible energy in this room. Can you feel that energy? This is the energy of courage and success. And the thing that I'm thinking of is that all of you are just a fraction of the families and students who have been helped by this program. This year, internationally, there's 105 schools, Barbara, I think you said that? And also throughout the last 40 years. Wow. Like me. 40 years ago, I began working on my learning disabilities. I took a chance on a program that at that time was basically unproven. But the theory was good. And my father was a lawyer, logical. And I decided that it was worth taking a chance on my future. Now, you graduates here, do I look old to you? Actually, I probably don't. I probably look really, really old.
Well, you have white hair.
I have white hair, that's right. That's the cue, isn't it? Okay, but I was the age, roughly the age of Division IV when I started working on my learning disabilities 40 years ago. I went on to university and I graduated with an honors degree. I've had several careers and I'm working on developing my next because I got downsized. And I went to a three-room school located on the top floor of the building in Yorkville. And there were five students in that school at the time. We worked hard. We worked really hard. And I know you guys have worked hard too. And I like to think that some of the data that came out of me at the time was turned into the programs that you are using now. Because a lot of what you talked about this morning, I didn't know about. A lot of those programs I didn't have access to. But that's okay. Because that was 40 years ago. And that's a really long time, and I'm really, really old, right? Okay. But Barbara's pioneering brain-based program was the reason that I came to Arrowsmith School, and it's the reason we're here today, right? So, okay, I am talented. I'm an amazing writer. I'm a great trainer and educator. I have exceptional communication skills. So I started with all of that good stuff. But every day for the last 40 years, I have been able to utilize those skills because of the work I did through the Arrowsmith program. The point is, I can use my talents freely. And I have been since I graduated from the program. Learning disabilities were like cobwebs through my brain, entering my potential. And Barbara's techniques took away those cobwebs. For 40 years, every day, I have benefited from the unlocked potential in me. And yeah, it took courage. Because I was used to being a failure. I was called, I had the label, the can-do better kid, which is a label that I actually developed to describe a person with learning disabilities who had been told all through school, you can do better than that. Why aren't you working harder? And they didn't realize I was working as hard as I could. I just couldn't produce any results. So, Barbara, you are a pioneer in neuroplasticity. With an international reputation, wow! Didn't see that one coming. Yeah, actually I did. And I am honored to present you with this award for your long-running contribution to this program. You have changed so many lives, and we are all so grateful. and your contribution began shortly before I met you 40 years ago. Please come up and accept this. Shows respect for others, works well with others, is kind and is honest, is determined and does not give up, is an overall positive member of the school community. However, the journey hasn't always been easy, yet this has not been a deterrent for this student. The student has worked at staying focused, on setting realistic goals, at managing frustration during those tough periods. This student has persevered and every day has tried to do just a little bit better than the day before. This student story is much like that of the Chinese bamboo tree. After planting its seed, this tree does not break ground for several years. However, after those years have passed, over a period of mere weeks, this tree can grow to 90 feet tall. Although the tree may have seemed dormant at first, it was using all those early years to develop sturdy roots. It is this strong foundation that allows the tree to reach its full potential. Similarly, the gains that this student has made in his final year at Arrowsmith are astounding, especially when one considers the starting point. On this student's first English report card, Mr. T noted that this student was lost during reading comprehension exercises and needed help and a lot of teacher redirection and teacher support. Now the student is able to work independently and reads for fun and can read and understand challenging material, and the student's vocabulary is flourishing. At the beginning of Arrowsmith, this student struggled to put ideas and thoughts on paper. Now the student regularly writes essays for the nightly journal writing. These pieces of writing are a far cry from the simple sentences that they were initially able to produce. They're now well organized, they're lengthy, they are thoughtful pieces of writing on advanced topics such as science, history, geography, and current events. When told homework was done for the year, just a couple of weeks ago, this student expressed sadness
and requested to continue journal writing until the last day of school, a concession the teachers were happy to make. The change in the students' math abilities had been equally, if not more, impressive. The student's mother shared that prior to attending Arrowsmith, this student had practically zero number sense. Now, this student has completed every level of Q-sense and flashcards. Someone who once struggled with basic mathematics can now do high school level algebra and has ended the year working on the highest level of math of all the students who have ever been in Ms. Howie's class. And 2 days ago, this student mastered eight-handed clocks. This award also goes to the student's family. The student and his mother had to travel from overseas to access our program. Last year, although they considered going home to reunite with their family, they ultimately made the difficult decision to stay one more year. Just like digging up the bamboo tree before it's ready would have negatively impacted his growth, they recognized this student needed another year to build his foundation, a decision that has allowed their child to reach his potential. So this year, the Director's Award goes to a truly deserving recipient, one who proves that patience, perseverance, and hard work can be achieved. Ethan Goldblatt.